श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे The type of questions when somebody asks, we know what is the standpoint that the person is asking this question. If we are able to understand this, then you will see that there are no questions in life. We have to only understand the standpoint. If we say that the loud music outside is disturbing everybody, so what is the standpoint? We are not the part of that noise. Therefore, it is disturbing. Now, those who are in that noisy gathering, for them it is a joy. Similarly, any question can be dissolved if we understand this basic principle. Let us try to fix the standpoint of the person who is asking this question. Then we will come to know that the real spiritual practice is we have to change our standpoint and try to understand what is the standpoint of the other person. Here in Kathopanishad, Sekandvalli, Nachiketa was given a lot of temptations so that his mind can be drifted from the third boon. What he has asked, this boon he asked number of times. First of all, he asked that there is a doubt among the people that what happens after death. Again, he asked the same question that what happens to the soul when he leaves the body. And both these questions, when they were asked, Nachiketa's guru, Yamaraj, tried to deceive him, take him here and there, by getting him involved in prakriti, in matter, in indulgence. And yet, the student Nachiketa was firm. He was not ready to compromise with anything in life but the truth. And therefore, again, third time, he asked the same question. He says, Anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat, अन्यत्र अस्मात् कृताकृतात् अन्यत्र भूताच्च भव्याच्च यत्तत् पश्यसि तद्वद। डोंट टेल मी आफ्टर डेथ इफ यू डू गुड कर्म यू गो टू हेवन, बैड कर्म यू गो टू हेल। आई एम नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन दैट। देन अन्यत्र धर्मात् अन्यत्र अधर्मात्, that which is beyond dharma and adharma. Dharma and adharma is in relation to a situation. So if you are getting lost in dharma adharma, you are lost in the relative world. You cannot come out of it. Because dharma adharma is karma based. सत्यं वद धर्मं चर स्वाध्यायान् मा प्रमदः आचार्याय प्रियं धनमारुत्य प्रजातन्तुं मा व्यवच्छेत्सि। सत्यान्न प्रमदितव्यं धर्मान्न प्रमदितव्यं भूत्यै न प्रमदितव्यं मातृदेवो भव पितृदेवो भव। हौ लॉन्ग आर यू गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद दिस फ्रेंड्स? Few seekers, they came separately, independently, different timings. Swamiji, yes. We are with so and so. Very good, continue. No, but now we are tired. What is the reason? We are told only one thing, do seva, do seva. How long are we going to do seva? What next? Another example. This pity or compassion is not a good thing. Don't have compassion. You think the other person is unfortunate. No. So there was one girl. Now she is in Chennai, mother of grown up children. I knew her when she was 10 years or 11 years. Very sweet, extremely intelligent, good in music, in Bharatanatyam, any field, she is number one. So she asked me, Swamiji, what should I study? I say, you take arts. Don't go into the routine, engineering, doctory, and who are the doctors who do not like healthy people? They don't like. If anybody healthy comes, healthy kahi ka. If unhealthy comes, heart. So, take two arts. So, she completed her graduation. Then, post-graduation. Swamiji, I am thinking, I want to do specialization in the challenged children. Somebody has got some defect, some problem. So those autistic type of children, I want to do specialization. Please bless me. I said, no, I will not bless. And if you go there, I will never talk to you. No, no, Swamiji, I will not do it. If you don't talk, then there is nothing important for me than you. Therefore, I will not do that. Then I said, do your post-graduation. And she did it. Then she did a school teacher job for a few days. Within 6 months, her genius was recognized by the committee and she became the education curriculum planning chief of the school. See? Within 1 or 2 years. And then now she is doing at a national, international level, planning the education curriculum for the different students, different age. So I told her, your abilities, you are spending on those children who will never change throughout life. Whole life you will be spending with them. What God has given you is for evolution. See? It's so important. So don't have that wrong notion. All the time, I do seva, I do this thing, that thing. You start feeling pity on the people. where you give some bhiksha or food left over to the beggars. That time, what is going on in our mind? Poor fellows, unfortunate, you know. Okay, take it. You are destroying your spiritual life. And this is what Dharma tells us. So here, Nachiketa says, how long I am going to serve the society? Then, be very attentive. Is the sun giving us the light and heat? He is not giving. Light and heat is his natural state. Do the flowers give the fragrance? They have the fragrance. Those who come nearer to them, they get benefited. The flower doesn't go from nose to nose. Think the purpose of our life is we must be an instrument through which the divine expresses. So knowing the truth can be only by being the truth. You cannot know the truth without being the truth. Therefore, Nachiket clearly tells, anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat, if you do this thing, you will go to hell. If you do this thing, you will go to heaven. I don't want both hell and heaven. You keep it. See? If you see Bhagavad Gita, most of the people, they glorify karma. See, Bhagavad Gita said, karma neva adhikara se ma phaleshu kadachana. But try to understand the meaning properly. See? Is Bhagavan telling that your right is only to do karma, not to the result? Then to whom the result will go? It will come to you only. And thus, by that, we are postponing our happiness in life. Therefore, the real meaning of that mantra will be, we are an instrument to express happiness through whatever means of expressions we have. The body, speech and mind. And when you are living happily, your life is fulfilled. Therefore, anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat, then anyatra asmat, kruta akrutat. Kruta is effect. Akruta is cause. Anyatra asmat, kruta akrutat. What is matter, prakriti? Matter or prakriti is nothing but the cause and effect matrix. See? Nobody has seen till date what is sattva guna, rajaguna, tamoguna. Then, world we see, we have the experience of the world. And what is the world? Three factors. Matter, activity, and knowledge. So the question is asked, what is the cause of matter? What is the cause of activity? What is the cause of knowledge? So the scriptures had to tell, oh, you are very intelligent because you are asking questions. And then they said, the cause of matter is tamoguna, the cause of now, dynamism, action is rajoguna, the cause of knowledge is sattvaguna, and we stop. Now see, basic principle. No cause can be established without reference to the effect. When we go to the doctor, what we do? We tell them the symptoms. Symptoms are effects. From the symptoms, the doctor arrives at the cause. This could be the cause. So, the cause is the cause of effect, or effect is the cause of cause. They are mutually dependent. mutually dependent things are supported by something which is independent of both. How simple it is. A digitally downloaded son was scolded by the traditional father. I gave you birth and you behave like this with me. Now this digital child said, Dad, enough is enough. Why? Who told me you gave me birth? So he started shaking. Now what Google Ananda has taught him? So he says, did anybody call you father before my birth? No. So you are because of me or I am because of you? Son and father relationship is mutually dependent. That is one of the reasons why I do not entertain question answer sessions. Why? Because the sky is too high. Every question takes you away from yourself. Do you have any question about your being? That is all. See, friends, therefore, anyatra asmat kruta kruta, then anyatra bhutachya bhavyachya, and that which is other than the principle of time, bhuta, the past, bhavishya, the future. Other than past and future, meaning other than time. The time that we understand and the time that is totally different. For us, time is past, present, future. That is not time. That is a measurement of time. When we say, 1 hour it will take to reach there. So 1 hour is a measurement of time. When we say 1 liter, is it an object? 1 liter what? See? When we say 5 kilometers, is it an object? Show 5 kilometers from here to there. So kilometer is a measurement of space. Friends, similarly, when we talk about time, time is also a measurement of something. And how that is born? Friends, it is born when a sequence is established. Sequence, our satsanga started, continued. In between, I took a nap. And then, when I woke up, it's still going on. Since how long it is going on? See? In between, there was no satsang because I was switched off. So, what we understand is the measurement of time which is established by respecting the sequence. Morning, wake up, event number 1. Then go to washroom, event number 2. Come to bedroom, event number 3. Go to sleep again, event number 4. Then you wake up again, event number 5. Oh God, it is 4 o'clock in the afternoon, but I woke up in the morning. Why it happened? Sequence. Now, don't allow a sequence to be established. When sequence cannot be established, that time there are no thoughts. Instead of catching this. We all the time talk about, in the last life this happened, next life this will happen. See friends, therefore, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha. If you do this thing, then you will get realized. I don't want in future, now and here. Yat tat pashyasi, what is your direct experience, that you tell me. Don't tell me theoretically. If you do this thing, your mind will be purified. You will chant the Lord's name. You will become single-pointed. Do yoga. You will become disciplined. And then don't tell me all that. Enough is enough. Tell me the truth. What is your experience? See? When this was said, now again, Yamaraj tries to avoid telling the student because he is being examined by the teacher. See? Sarve Veda Yat Padam Amananti Tapamsi Sarvani Cha Yat Vadinti Yadichanto Brahmacharyam Charanti Tatte Padam Sangraheda Pravimi Omitte Dada. So the teacher says, Sarve Veda Yat Padam Amananti. All the Vedas, they are padam padyate iti padam, that is to be reached. All the scriptures talk about that destination. Tapamsi sarvani cha yad vadanti. All the tapasvis and seekers, they are working only for this. And yadi chanto brahmacharyam charanti, desiring this reality, the seekers of truth, they follow the brahmacharya. Tatte padam sangrahena bravimi. I shall tell you in short. Not a big lecture. In short. What is that? Om itte tada. This Om. Om on this. Mandukya Upanishad gives a very exhaustive commentary. Very beautiful. I'll tell you in short. We have heard Om so many times, but the Om is a spota, it is called. It is a khichdi of three, A, U and Ma. When we chant A, no efforts are required. You simply throw the air through your vocal cord and A happens. A. But if you have to say OOM, then you have to twist your tongue, your mouth. OOM. How long will you keep on talking? Till your lips are open. When the lips close, no talk. So what is the last? MA. MA is a labial. When the two lips touch together, then only MA can be said. Try to say MA without touching the lips to each other. Cannot. So what is the meaning of OM? The complete language is included from the A to the MA. OM. There was a girl, maybe 5-7 years before going to school, she used to go to the temple and stand before the Lord, close her eyes. And after some time, she used to chant something. The Panditji was watching. This small little girl comes alone, stands before the Lord, says something and goes. One day, 2 days, 2 weeks. Then he thought, let me ask what she understands about prayer. They're just a small baby. So he asked, what you do? You do prayers? Yes. Do you know what is prayer? I said, I don't know. She said, I don't know. Then what do you do? I do whatever I know. So what do you know? I know ABCD. So I stand before the Lord and say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Lord, I don't know the prayer, but these are the alphabets which are used for the prayer. So you adjust them properly and that is my prayer. See? How beautiful it is. When Om is said, your all prayers are done. And in this Om, the Ma has to be lengthened. Normally, people lengthen the O. O. Like the early morning, 4 o'clock, there are some places throughout our country, or some dogs together, they come and start. O. Instead of early morning chirping of the birds, crying of the dogs. So, extend ma. Om. Your whole body, each and every cell, is slowly cooled down. Mind slowly gives up the shape of the body and the individual mind merges in the total mind. See? Like if a pot is empty, there is a space inside, space outside. Therefore, we will be talking about pot space and total space. But when the pot walls are broken, will the pot space come out to go to the total space? Because the pot is in the space. Exactly the same way. Our body is in the mind. But we are so occupied with our body that we make this funny thing. I am inside the body, world is outside the body. So when the pot was broken, we come to discover that the pot was in the space. In the same manner, in deep sleep, when the body identification is discarded temporarily, that time the pot space has merged with the total space. In the same manner, the individual mind merges with the total mind. And it is this total mind which is maintaining life in the body. Therefore, when we are thus understanding and then practicing something, then it has an impact. Therefore, Tatte Padam Sangrahita Bravimi Omitte Tada. Now this Om is further divided in a very exhaustive way. O stands for the waker in the waking Vishwa. O stands for dreamer in the dream Tejas. Ma stands for the Prajna in the deep sleep. All of them are supported by the Turiya, the fourth one, who is supporting the waking experiences of the waker, dream experiences of the dreamer, and deep sleep experiences of the deep sleeper, and yet not contaminated by any one of them. So this Om, if you want to remember how to remember, Om is the man. When he is identified with the father, he has become son. Or when he got identified with the wife, he has become husband. Oh. When he is identified with his son, he has become father. Ma. So who is man? The fourth one, the Turiya. Is he the fourth one? He is the one. But that the one has become many as if because identified with the gross body, subtle body, causal body. Then who is miserable? It is these three guys who do not exist, they are miserable. So what will be the spiritual practice? What your role you have to play as a waker, etc. Play the role. Don't get rolled up in that. Friends, this is the meaning of home. So the Turiya, the fourth, is essentially the only one. Why we call it fourth? Because our attention is on the waker, dreamer and deep sleeper. So, glorifying this Omkar further, etat devaksharam brahma, etat devaksharam param, etat devaksharam jnatva, yu yadichyati tasya tat. He who understands this reality, akshara, naksharati iti akshara. Akshara means that is that which is not subject to destruction, is called akshara. So, etat devaksharam brahma, this, the Turiya is essentially the Brahman. Therefore, in Yoga Shastra, they say Turiyatita. Because Turiya is also with reference to the three. But absolute standpoint, even the three are not there, therefore fourth is also not there, then what remains is Ekameva Dvitiya Neha Nanastikita. So, Eta Devaksharam Brahma. This is the ultimate reality, Bruhatvat Brahma, Eta Devaksharam Param. This is the ultimate to be attained in one's life. And Eta Devaksharam Jnatva, he who thus recognizes this as his essential nature, Yo Yadichyati Tasya Tat. Thereafter, he has the ability, whatever may be the desire, that desire stands fulfilled. Now be attentive. It's a big catch here. If I do this thing, what will I get? Oh, all your desires will be fulfilled. And therefore you do. You are not walking spiritual path. Therefore, here we have to clearly understand. Whatever he desires, his desires stand fulfilled. Means what? He has no desires. Living at zero desire level is abidance in the truth. Can there be any desire for the space? No, this or should not keep on moving. I get tickly all the time. And the ocean is making me wait, I get surly sometimes. No. Why? Because the space is not touched by anything. Therefore, no desire, good or bad. Therefore, friends, the real spiritual practice is this. Yada sarve pramuchyante kama yasya vridishyata. When we entertain zero desires, then alone we are abiding in the truth. Etat alambanam sreshtam, etat alambanam param, etat alambanam jnatva, brahma loke mahiyate. So, when we thus take this as support, then brahma loke among the wise people, we are accepted with respect and reverence. Brahma loke mahiyate. Now what is that reality? Now the teacher says, na jayate mriyate vak vipashtit nayam bhutvap. Oh, this is from Bhagavad Gita. It has so deeply gone inside. The same mantra is stolen by Bhagavan Krishna. He was not only the makan chor, but the mantra chor also. There are many mantras in Bhagavad Gita, which are directly taken from the scriptures, Upanishad. Na jayate mriyate va vipaschit, na yam kutaschit, na bhavuva kaschit, ajo nitya shashvato yam purana, na hanyate hanyamane sharire. Now see, na jayate, not born, na mriyate, no death. So, neither birth nor death. So in between, what is there in between? Asti jayate, asti viparidamate, apakshiyate, and vinashati iti shad vikaravat edastulam sharira. What is the body? Body is in the womb, it is born, it grows, then it modifies, it becomes old, and one day it dies. So, body is sorted out. It cannot be the truth. Na jayate mriyate va vipaschit, this absolute conscious being that we are, nayam kutaschit na bahu vakaschit, neither it is produced by anything, nor it produces anything. Who? The reality that we are. So, where it is said, neither it produces nor it is produced, means what? It is neither the cause nor the effect. His question was, same thing. Anyatra dharmat, anyatra dharmat, anyatra asmat, kruta kruta, kruta kruta, akruta. The effect and the cause, here also. Nayam kutaschenna babu vakaschit is, it is beyond the cause and effect. The same thought in Bhagavad Gita, 7th chapter, Bhagavan says. Mattaha parataram nanyat kinchidasti dhananjaya mai sarvavidam prodam sutre manigana iva. There is no superior than me as the cause. There is no inferior than me as an effect. There is nothing other than me as other. See? Then what is this world? This world is me alone. See? So, ajo nitya nayam kutaschidna bhavo kaschid ajo nitya shashvato yam puranaha. So the self that we are, the Brahman that is ajaha, unborn. If you take even one word and work on it, ajaha, unborn, do we have the experience of birth? But we are told right from childhood, happy birthday, happy birthday. And slowly, slowly we start taking it. Yes, I was born. Na ajaha de nityaha, we are ever the same. We are not changed. The world around us has changed. The body has changed. Our abilities have changed. Our priorities have changed. But we are the same. Nityaha. The best part is, we don't have to do anything. As child, what were our priorities? What were our points of attraction? Now we are grown up. Now who is grown up? The body is grown up. We are the same. He prays. Nitya shashvataha ayam puranaha. Shashvata is unchanging. It is ever the same. And puranaha, although it is the most ancient one, yet it has never become old because no impact of time. Therefore, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha. He was asking, what is that which is beyond the scope of time? This is what you are beyond the scope of time. Nahanyate hanyamane sharire. And therefore, when the body is destroyed, nothing happens to us. That is the reality. Whether you want or you don't want, it is the truth. There is one text. Sarat Sujatiya, very beautiful text. There, it is systematically proved, death is an illusion. Death is not possible. Death is not. So here, Bhagavan says, हन्ता चेत् मन्यते हन्तुम् हतश्चेत् मन्यते हतम् उभौ तौ न विजानीतः नायं हन्ति न हन्यते इफ समबडी थिंक्स आई एम गोइंग टू किल हिम एंड इफ समबडी इमेजिन्स आई एम बीइंग किल्ड बाय समवन एल्स उभौ तौ न विजानीतः बोथ ऑफ देम आर बेवकूफ बिकॉज नायं हन्ति न हन्यते द ट्रूथ द सेल्फ द रियालिटी दैट वी आर is neither killing nor getting killed. Therefore, be attentive. After studying Kathopanishad or after studying scriptures or after going to satsanga, if a passing thought about our death comes in our mind, whatever we have done till date, is gone away to Gangaji. There is no death. See? What is death? And what is birth? See? When we leave a place, that place is dead for us. We are the same. See? When I came here on the 1st of February, I was born here. Then I am going today. When I leave Hyderabad, Hyderabad is dead for me. I am the same. Then I am in Mumbai. There I am born. Then again next day I will be again leaving Bombay. So, Bombay is dead for me. I am the same. Childhood body we discarded. Did we change? Childhood dead, not me. Teenage dead, not me. Middle age dead, not me. Old age will die, not me. Marne bhi nahi dete. See, my friends. Therefore, Ubhautav na vijanitaha, those who think that I die and what will happen after death, what will then, don't worry. Nobody is born, nobody dies. You know why this fear comes? We have this notion that because of us the world is moving. There was a bullock cart carrying a huge load of grass. Two bullocks were pulling. June, very hot climate in South India. And one dog was going below that bullock cart. And all the rest, Basrika he was. And after some time, the cart man parked the cart below a tree, gave some water to the bullocks, and unyoked them, and he also took little rest. That time, the dog also came out. So he was asked, why are you tired? Are you tired? I was carrying the whole bullock cart till here. See? We are like that. Because of me, everything is happening. If I go, I don't know what will happen. See, friends, ahankara vimudatma karta aham iti manyate. Or, ubhau tau na vijanati nayam hanti na hanyate. What is that reality then? The teacher says, anoho anihyan mahato mahiyan atmasya jantor nito guhayam tamakratuhu pashyati vita shokaha dhatu prasadat mahimanam atmanaha. Now this reality, what was said, na jayate mriyate vami pashit, nayam bhutva bhavita vana bhuyaha. What is that reality? Anoho aniyan, mahato mahiyan. Subtler than the subtlest. Anoho aniya. What is the grossest? Earth. Subtler than the earth, water. subtler than the water, fire. Subtler than the fire, air. Subtler than the air, space. Subtler than the space. Think. When we are in deep sleep, where are we? Meaning space. Whether we are in Hyderabad or we are somewhere else. Therefore, subtler than the space is what? Mind. Subtler than the mind is what? I. Subtler than the I is life. In coma, deep sleep, there is no I, but life is there. Subtler than the life is that which is beyond life and death, jada chetan, that is the ultimate. Anoho aniyan. Therefore, in one of the mantras, it is said, यच्छेद वांग मनसी प्राज्ञ तद्यच्छेद ज्ञान आत्मनि महतीनि यच्छेद तद्यच्छेद शांति आत्मनि यच्छेद वांग मनसी प्राज्ञ. The wise man should withdraw his speech in the mind. How to withdraw the speech in the mind? The same way as we withdraw the ice in the water. So ice gasified is water. Water ungasified is mind. Is water. See, the ice ungasified is water. Come back to the same thing. Mind gasified is speech. When the mind is quiet, it is mind. Rather, when the speech is quiet, it is mind. Therefore, great sadhana, we told you. Dekho, suno, mat bolo. We remain at the mind level. But what happens? The moment any perception comes, we have a comment. Then give it a try. Either keep quiet, or if you have to talk, don't take anything seriously. Listen lightly, that no impact should be on our mind after hearing. Like we are hearing Vedanta, no impact. Again the same thing. Therefore, anoho aniyan, subtler than the subtlest. Then mahato mahiyan, is bigger than the biggest. So the space can be accommodated in the eye of a needle, anoho aniyan, and the space can accommodate millions of galaxies. Anoho aniyan, mahato mahiyan. Now this space is where? In the mind. And what is the mind? Expression of the Chaitanya. What is the Chaitanya? Chaitanya is the expression of the Chaitanya. Therefore, where is the whole world? Anoho aniyan, mahato mahiyan. Then, atma sa jantoho nihito guhaya. This atma, this reality, this Brahman, jantoho guhayam nihitaha. Is very much 100% available in his own heart. Now this example which I give you, kindly reflect on it. We are like a suitcase. In the suitcase there are so many things packed. And we are short of space. So the only way is empty the suitcase. Space is already there. In the same manner, we have got so many things stuffed in us. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya, friends, enemies, achievement, failure, relations, possessions. As a result, the divine that we are is covered by all this rubbish. As you start emptying yourself, when you start emptying yourself, you start unbecoming. When I took divorce, I unbecame the husband. So when I unbecame the husband, then was it a loss or a gain? Nothing. Then what was revealed? Man was revealed. Dear friends, therefore, Atma Jantoho Guhaya Nihitaha, the self is very much our essential nature. You don't have to do anything outside, only empty yourself. Enough of this. Shatrau Mitre Putre Bandhav Ma Kuru Yatnam Vigraha Sandhav. Don't create friends and enemies and carry the burden of that in your life. Atma Se Janto Nihito Guhaya. Therefore, when you are at peace, like the eyes are open, seeing is happening, but a seer is not born. That was the experience of Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi. Nay, that was Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi. Seeing is happening, but seer is not born. Hearing is happening, hearer is not born. There is experience, doesn't matter good or bad, but experiencer is not born. This is what Bhagwan says, Sukha Dukke Same Krutva Labha Labho Jaya Jayo Tato Yudhayo Yujaswa Naivam Papam Avapsasi. When you are leading your day-to-day life, sometimes you succeed, sometimes you fail. Sometimes you gain, sometimes you lose. Sometimes you get happiness, sometimes miseries. Bhagwan says, Same Krutva, be equanimous to them, meaning don't react, meaning don't become a successful person or a failure person. Don't become a happy man or a miserable man. Just be. Naivam papam avapsasi. You shall not incur sin. What is the sin? Sin is when our interaction with the world creates impressions on our mind, good or bad. It is a sin. There cannot be sin without merit. There cannot be joy without misery. There cannot be birth without death. The world is made up of these complementary opposites. Therefore, we have to remove this all garbage. Then, tam akratuhu pashyati vita shokaha. Then who can recognize his own divine nature? First is akratuhu. Akratuhu means he who has gone beyond. I have to do this, I have to do that. Enough of doing, now relax. Then, Vita Shokaha Enam Pashyati. Vita Shokaha, he who is not brooding over the past, good or bad of the life. Just drop it. Vita Shokaha. Otherwise, small little keeps us busy unnecessarily. I tell you how it happens. One example. In Mumbai, I was attending some marriage. That is one of my professional requirements. I have not married, but I have to attend the marriages of other people. And that is what I enjoy. Because that is the only time they are happy and I am happy. Afterwards, I continue to be happy. Fill in the gaps. I don't know. So, after that photography, all that kind of drama, then my interest is food. So, I took my food and sat. That very time, one old lady came with a stick in the hand and walked out. Swamiji, what are you doing? I said, I am dancing. Why are you telling like that? I said, when you see I am eating, why you are asking this stupid question? Have you seen that girl? I said, I have not seen, come here to see the girls. I come to take food. You know, I am feeling so sorry. Why? You want to get married again? No, then if my daughter was alive, she would have been married like this. Oh, I'm so sorry, Amma. When did she die? Yesterday, day before yesterday? No, she died when she was 6 months old. Now, this old lady is 85, you're not out. And she is carrying the burden of the child which died at 6 months of age throughout life. Who can help her? See, Yage Reke Amritatva Manashu. When you give up on your own, it is a joy. When somebody snatches it from you, it is a misery. See? Suppose somebody pickpockets and takes, and there are only 10 rupees. Yet we are hurt, isn't it? Oh God, that fellow has taken my money. How much 10 rupees? So 10 rupees, nobody, even then he has stolen it. Okay. And then you come to me, and this is just an example, don't take it as a suggestion, okay? Then you come to me and give me $1 million as dakshina. That time also, you are parting away with your money, and somebody has pickpocketed and taken only 10 rupees. That 10 rupees loss was painful because it was gone in ignorance. And when you yourself gave, it is a joy. Simple life's principles are tam akratu upashyati vita shokaha. And therefore, yesterday also I told you, don't talk about your past and your story. Nobody is interested. See, I was there, this happened, and therefore, who asked you? Is it Ramayana? That we have to tell our story. Don't tell anything anybody. Don't ask anything anybody. Then what to talk? Talk about weather. Talk about the environmental crisis in the whole world. Talk about the government. Talk about the government corruption. All these topics create no sin because they are illusions. When you talk about illusions, there is no sin. Suppose you say, oh, the mirage water was very tasty. Total lie, is it not? It's not a sin. Exactly. You talk about the world, but it is not a sin. Don't give it too much importance. Be the shokaha. Mind will be free. And then, dhatu prasadar, mahimanam atmanaha. And when your mind is, dhatu is the mind, prasadar, when your mind is at peace with yourself. Bhagavan Krishna says, prasade sarva dukkhanam hanirasya upajayate. Prasanna chetaso yashu buddhi parihavatishtate. Prasade, when we get the prasad, what is our attitude and interaction? When we get prasad, we feel blessed. Second thing, we do not compare the prasad given to us and given to others. You are given him more, less to me. No. We don't want to improve the prasad. Suppose somebody has given us something sweet. We'll say, thoda achar de do. No. See, when we take every event of our life as divine grace, you will never be miserable in life. Nothing happens in life wrong for us. Everything is perfect. Take life as the divine blessings. Therefore, dhatu prasada, and for that the technique is our Mahamantras. Wherever you are, be 100%. Don't worry. No, but after here, we have to go there. Then blah, 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 blah. Try these two things. When you talk to others, you talk about your past. Stop that. When you talk to yourself, you talk about the future. Stop that. And when you are in the present, you can see this world from a different standpoint. Like a child. When the mother, father and the child, they are going somewhere. The father is worried about how much money we have to spend. The wife is worried about how many things I can buy. And the child is playing with the garden. Therefore, Dhatu Prasadat, Mahimanam Atmanaha, our greatness of being divine is possible if we are at peace with ourselves. And therefore, we told you, Ashantasya Kutas Sukham, a person who is not at peace can never, never be happy. Now, this reality, Asino Duram Rayati, Shayano Yati Sarvataha, Kastam Madam Madam Devam. Asinaha duram rajati. Now see the contradiction. Sitting in one place, the reality goes everywhere. How it is possible? How did you come to this Ramanashram? By sitting in the car. Asinaha duram rajati. So the upadhi, the car was moving. I was not moving. In the same manner, wherever there is anything in that existence, truth alone is. Therefore, asinaha duram prajati. We don't have to go anywhere. Everything is with us. Then, shayano yati sarvataha. When we have dreams going here and there, we don't go physically. We can create anything, go anywhere. To that, madamadam devam kahatam madanyaha jnatumarhati. To that divine self that I am, how it can be recognized as other than I? See, mad anyaha jnatum kaha arhati? Who can know the truth by remaining separate from the truth? Knowing is being and being is knowing. Hold on to this principle. Don't have that knowledge. I want God realization. Friends, remove the curtain, remove the garbage, and the truth is revealed. Remember, you do not get reality, you express reality if you remove the cover. There was a bulb, and it was lit, and on that bulb, there was one thin cloth. Then there was a bed sheet. Then there was a blanket, then there was a quilt, and then there was a tarpaulin. Will we be able to see the light? What we do? Remove the tarpaulin, gross body. Remove the quilt, the vijnanamaya kosha. Remove the blanket, the manomaya kosha. Remove the bed sheet, pranamaya kosha. Remove the thin cloth, Anandamaya Kosha, the light will be coming out. Therefore, whenever we are happy, divine is expressing through us in full glory. But when we are dim, then there is some covering on us. The covering is that of the relations. Because of somebody or the other, we are Kastam madamadam devam madanya jnatumarhati. Therefore, we can never know the truth by being other than the truth. Ashariram shariresho anavasteshu avasvitam mahantam vibhumatmanam matva adhirona shojati. Therefore, although in the body, yet beyond the limitations of the body. See, although I am a husband, but I am beyond the limitations of the husband. What are the limitations of the husband? Husband's limitations are, he is conditioned by the mirror of wife. So what I had to do? I had to only know that the reflection in the mirror appears But it is not real. It is useful for the hairstyle, for putting the things in the right place. It is useful. So use the husband. But don't take it seriously. Be friends. Ashariram Shariresh. Although functioning through the conditioning of body, etc., yet not limited by the conditioning, Mahantam Vibhum Atmanam Matva, and thus this divine self that we are, Mahantam, infinite, Vibhum, everywhere, Atmanam Matva, having recognized this as our essential nature, Giraha Na Shochati. He will cease to be miserable in life. Come back to our mantra. Therefore, Mauj Me Raho, be happy. In one place where I go regularly for talks in Mumbai, there was some function. And in that function, as it was a different function than my routine satsanga. So they say, Swamiji, we all know you, and now this time, kindly tell us something different than Mauj Me Raho. Because any topic given to you, you come back to be happy. Tell us something different. I said, all right. Then I started. And 15 minutes, they became so miserable. Swamiji, come back to yourself. Real spiritual practice is being happy. Real samsara is struggling to become happy. See the difference? When you become, you struggle. In being, there is no struggle. And therefore, Nayam Atma Pravachanena Labhyaha. There's one more mantra here. Ashariram Sharireha Vidya Dandisika. Nayam Atma Pravachanena Labhyaha. Namedaya Na Bahuna Shrutena. Yamai Vecha Vrunate Tena Labhyaha. Tasesha Atma Vivrunate Tanum Swam. Ayam Atma Pravachanena Givena. Or Pravachanena Lisanena Nalabhyaha. By giving the lectures or by listening the lectures, you don't get the truth. Nalabhyaha. Then, na medhayana bhavanashrutena, remembering mantras of the Upanishads and Gita and quoting left and right, it has nothing to do with realization. And bhavanashrutena, I have heard so many Mahatmas, all of them have failed. So you try. Bhavanashrutena. Then, yamai vesha vadate dena labhyaha, he who seeks the truth to the exclusion of everything, to him alone the truth is revealed. From the other point of view, when yamai vesha vrudate, yam esha, esha atma, the paramatma, he who chooses, to him the truth is revealed, both ways. So our efforts are remain effortless in life. Our spiritual practice is undoing all what we have been doing. Our attainment is the degree of unbecoming. Then, to such a Mahatma seeker, Paramatma reveals himself. If we have to give something, a child, and the child says, okay, elder people are doing, they are lifting the water in a bucket and taking, I also want. So what we will do, we'll give him a plastic bucket, small size. Okay, you take it. No, you are taking big, give me big bucket. So as we don't give because he is not capable, in the same manner, the truth is not revealed, unless we are capable. In the life of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, some of his relations, and they said, Bhagwan, why don't you give us the experience? He said, not now. Why? You are not capable of receiving. You may be my brother. You may be my disciple. But I know whether you are capable or not. If I give you, you will die. Really, yes. They don't give. See, friends, therefore, real spiritual practice is this. We don't seek anything in life, including God. And for all of us, the highest ideal on the earth today is Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi. He's there. Just be. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. Whatever drama we have to do, do the drama. And afterwards, breakfast is there. And what else? Yamai Veshavanute Dinarabhyaha. The Sesha Atma Vivrute Dhanuswam. To that seeker alone, the truth is revealed by the divine grace. Na Girato Dushcharitat, Na Shanto Na Samahitaha, Na Shanta Manaso Vapi, Prajnane Neham Apnaya. Na Girato Dushcharitat, he who has not withdrawn from the wrong lifestyle, he whose mind is not at peace with himself, and Nashanta Manasovapi, and he who is unable to maintain the coolness of his life, Prajnanena Napnuyat. Only by studying, reading, nothing happens. We have to be qualified to know the truth. And ultimately, Yamaraj say, Yasya Brahma Chakshatram Cha Ubhe Bhavata Odanaha Mrityu Asya Upasechanam Ka Ittha Vela Yatra Saha. Yasya brahmacha kshatram cha ubhe bhavata odanaha. For him, both brahma kshatra. Brahma is jnana shakti, kshatra is kriya shakti. Both of them dissolve in him. Therefore, nothing to do, nothing to know. Jnana shakti and kriya shakti dissolve. What happens with us? Three stages. Janati, Ichchati, Karoti. When we know something, then we desire that and then we get involved in activity. When we do not know something, we do not desire. Like many of us, because we knew that there is a satsang here, therefore we desired and we came. Now those who do not know that there is a satsang here, they will not desire, they will not come. So, when our jnana shakti is under control, what is the control? Jnana shakti, dekho suno, see here, no reaction. How simple it is. But we continue to remain as it is. So what happened to the jnana kriya shakti? Odana, we have eaten them. Meaning, our ability to have perfect control over jnana and kriya shakti. What is the control over jnana shakti? We don't want to know anything about anybody. See? Mind is quiet. And we don't want to do anything. Whatever is to be done, as a routine, you do it, that's it. Net result, we will be at peace. And that is what is said here, Ubhe Bhavata Odanaha, both Jnana Kriya Shakti, they will not torture us, we will eat them away. Mrityu Asya Upasechanam, and death is the chutney. Upasechanam chutney, meaning what? We will not be talking, thinking, afraid of death. the topic of death will be deleted from our system. This is how Nachiketa was with Yamaraj, and this Yamaraj appreciated the student because of his dispassion and commitment to the cause. And this is possible for every seeker if we are clear in our understanding. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.